So then, Joe, I feel like I'm in consumer unit corner today.
Absolutely.
And it looks like you've brought something that would be best placed on the Antiques Roadshow, because in this video presentation, we're going to look at the evolution of the consumer unit and overcurrent protection.
Yeah, absolutely. And you can see here, we're looking at something here that is pretty much decades old, I think it's fair to say, isn't it? This is a very old consumer unit that would have come out of probably a domestic installation.
Yes.
And there's a few kind of things to point out on here. First of all, if you have a consumer unit that looks like this in your home, it might be time to start thinking about getting an electrician in to have a little look at your installation, because chances are it could be made safer. So what's some points of interest on here, guys?
Well, for me, if we're doing the Antiques Roadshow, there's some lovely dovetail joints here. I said, whoever's made this has gone about it in a beautiful way.
Yeah.
And nothing better than a bit of brown wood, I think, when you're on the old Antiques Roadshow.
Absolutely.
However,
it is genuinely a beautiful thing, isn't it? It's really well made. It looks like it's been handcrafted. It's not been, you know, sort of mass produced in the factory. Some real tender loving care gone into that. But as you say, perhaps there's some safety issues here.
We know that to enter an electrical enclosure, we must use a tool or a key.
Yep.
So how was it entered when it was completely intact, Joe?
There was a little hook on the side here.
A hook.
And the hook's gone now, so it's even less safe than it was before. And that little hook simply undid with no key, no screwdriver, no tool beyond your finger.
Okay.
So what that meant was that you could very, very quickly and easily access the internals of this consumer unit. So, again, quick access into the live parts of a consumer unit, possibly not the best thing in the world.
So we're used to perhaps taking a posi drive screwdriver on a domestic consumer unit and unscrewing the front after safe isolation procedure, or we're perhaps used to using a key on a more industrial style distribution board. So we're in. So with relative ease, would there be any other issues once I'm in there, John?
Well, the live buzz bar is actually clearly visible just under there.
So here can, is
yes,
the...
Yes, you're touching a live buzz bar there now. Yeah.
I'm sure it's isolated because it's on the
yeah, table. we should be okay.
So you're saying there's no plastic guard or shield, so there's nothing to protect, the
no
actual...
barriers.
The enclosure's opened by no effort, and there's no barriers once we get in there. So already we're running the risk of massive risk of electric shock, and we know that those facilities are in a modern consumer unit. We're used to seeing the plastic guard, aren't we, over the front of a buzz bar, or the star breaker design, which we use at college, which therefore doesn't
completely require... enclosed buzz bar.
Yeah, it's really good. So we're also suggesting the internal IP rating's not going to be IP2X, so we're going to be poking our fingers at live parts, Joe, so that's not very clever either.
Nope.
I always like to see means of isolation built into my consumer unit. Now, we can't suggest that it wasn't remote from the consumer unit itself, so it might have been an isolator remote from it. We didn't take this one out, but there is no built-in double pole or linked main switch.
There's no main switch here at all, is there? So, again, potentially, it would be very, very easy to open this up and it all still be very, very live inside there.
Okay, so another downside, I would suggest. Is there a downside with it being made out of such beautiful brown wood, Joe?
Again, the craftsmanship is phenomenal. However, we've moved on a little bit in recent years to metal enclosures, and this is made of a highly combustible material. But the good thing is it's been coated in another even more highly combustible material. So I think, it's fair to say that the leap from the wooden boards that perhaps we used to install. I honestly don't remember ever installing one of these. That was a little bit before my time.
You've thrown it at me that I might have done.
Only you can answer that, Gary. And we're now looking at, obviously, we've gone through the sort of the plastic years, haven't we? And now we're down to metal consumer units. And really, this is the safest it's been, really, isn't it?
And that's what we do when we evolve things. So if we look back at the original petrol car, and we look where we're going now with a battery vehicle, that's evolution of, obviously, that... mode of transport. So we've got overcurrent protection devices, which is a big tick.
Yes, okay, thank goodness for that.
But we've got them in the style, Joe, of a rewireable fuse.
Keep that away from me there,
You've
Gary.
You've got a bit of a phobia about the white padding that is on
indeed.
There. What is it?
Again, we've got a little layer of asbestos in there.
Another winner.
Yeah, which is obviously deeply worrying because that is highly, highly lethal to human beings, so that's not the kind of thing we want to be getting involved with. It's there just to damp the arc, isn't it, to contain the arc when the metal fuse wire there blows. But obviously if you come across one of these in the wild, that's not something you want to be messing around with, really.
So what happens is a piece of copper wire, it doesn't look copper because it's usually tinned, a piece of copper wire is strapped between the two points, is smaller than the actual conductor. In the event of excess current, we melt this piece of copper rather than the copper that's in the conductor, and the asbestos will obviously hold that energy and hopefully allow it to melt away. Mm-hmm. And you can see how we've moved on, and I almost feel now that this is the poorer family of overcurrent protection devices, the simple miniature circuit breaker. Great, does its job. It's got a lot more technology built into it than a piece of fuse wire. But we've moved even possibly away from these in a majority of cases in domestic dwellings, Joe. We've gone over and we went then to this. This is a Crabtree version, so it's a star breaker one, so slightly different than that one. So what functions did this have, Joe?
So there we've got the built-in RCD technology, making that an RCBO, because it combines the benefits of both the miniature circuit breaker and also RCD protection as well. So you can see there, great bit of kit. But the other issue we've got there as well is this sort of giant lump on the top of it here to accommodate all of that RCD equipment inside there. However, we've gone even beyond that now. What are we looking at now, Gary?
We took a small leap forward when we miniaturised that device, so it became the same size as what seems a standard MCB. So we've got a miniature RCBO, so all the technology was just shrunk down into one device. And then we continue on, don't we? The evolution goes on again, and we're just at that breaking point between two parts here, because we've now got the arc fault detection device, this one being star breaker design type, this one being a buzz bar type. So we've got those now. We've got the miniature RCBO, Joe, and we've incorporated it with what device?
So strapped onto the side of that now, we've got an AFDD, an arc fault detection device, which obviously is something that is developing through the regs as time goes on. We're seeing an increased impression on that now. However, as again you can see there, that's now taking up two ways in a consumer unit. So that's kind of starting to bulk out your consumer unit a little bit more again. If only there was another solution.
Yeah, so what's happened is we're pending one, we're pending two actually, being delivered to the college to show our learners that actually they've taken the technology of the arc fault detection device and crushed it into one device itself. We've done a small video on it already, but we'll do some videos on perhaps fitting those and the benefits of fitting those, etc. There is a couple of downsides to these, isn't there? Insulation resistance tests, which we've done videos on, which will be solved when the end of November 2019 we get hopefully our hands on a miniaturised version of that. That's big leaps, isn't it, in short periods
very
of time.
So, yeah.
We've gone maybe from this style of consumer unit back, what would you suggest, 40s?
Yeah, probably around then, And then we've sort of seen the development through that, haven't we? The first sort of Bakelite boards that sort of came in, and then the sort of more modern plastics that have been developed over time. But it does seem that there's been sort of an acceleration in recent years, isn't there, from that. So, this really was the standard protective style for a long time. And suddenly now we've sort of, over a relatively short period of time, we've just come on in leaps and bounds, as we've just briefly described to you there.
Other things to point out inside this lovely piece of furniture is the fact that we've got a neutral bar, but we haven't got a bar to get the protective conductors. So there is no what we would call earth bar in there for your earthing conductor, protective bonding or CPCs. And when I took out one of these previously, which got unfortunately thrown away, so we were pleased to see this, had about a 10-year gap, we're not seeing one of these, is that anything that had a CPC was just twisted together in the board.
So it was often with nothing actually clamping them, no connector block, certainly not a Vargo. Just absolutely, just twisted together, and you hope for the best, which it sort of gives you chills now, doesn't it, when you think about it?
It does. And when you think now, on top of this sort of stuff, we might be considering putting in surge protection devices that we see down here. We've taken massive leap forward in a relatively short space of time, maybe in the last 10 years, we've made huge gains. So that was a little trip down memory lane. Not for me, I didn't fit any either, but looking at what looks like a nice piece of furniture, but actually did a job for a period of time. But as we look at it now, Joe, we don't believe it's doing the safest possible job that it could do. And the regulations continue to change to improve safety. Do you want to end it?
Shall we do it?
Yeah. We hope this video has been some help. One of our students, I think it was Jim. Did Jim bring it in? One of our students.
It wasn't a donation from Mr. Ward, was it?
No. Don't take your ID badge off.
Oh, yeah. Apologise.
I apologise
for one, I apologise.
I like that one, I prefer that one. Back to that again, are we? Here we go then, so.
I need a holiday.
So we've got zero prep for this. this, and here we go. Let's see what this looks like.
Nothing.